Welcome to Preston Station, the heart of the Blackpool branches, Preston, Blackpool and Ormskirk route. Situated on the West Coast Main Line, halfway between the stations at London Euston and Glasgow Central, it's a vital link for passengers travelling to the famous and popular seaside holiday destination of Blackpool, as well as other parts of the country. Looks like there's a missing route map over there. Let's head over to it and fix it whilst you're here. There are a lot more tasks for us now, so be sure to find and replace the missing route maps and enjoy eating the gingerbread. Ormskirk is famed for gingerbread. Fix the broken signs, collect the golf bags and have fun with building sandcastles. Take a seat anywhere you like. Our journey begins at Preston, which opened in 1838, as part of the key West Coast Main Line from London to Glasgow. It forms a central pivot point for the route and is an important interchange for trains throughout northwest England. It provides connections from places such as Colne and Ormskirk to trunk services to Glasgow and London, among others. Services from Preston to York are also a regular feature. However, the bulk services leaving the station head to Manchester via Bolton. Blackpool once had three stations, Blackpool North, Central and South. Blackpool Central was closed in 1964, however, the North and South stations still exist for you to explore. Formerly known as Blackpool Talbot Road, Blackpool North is now the main terminating station in the town. This station once comprised 16 platforms, but was cut down to 8 when the original station building was demolished and relocated to its current location. Blackpool South, formerly known as Waterloo Road, was made the sole terminus of the southern end of the town when Central Station closed in 1964. This train is the British Rail Class 142 diesel mechanical multiple unit in the provincial blue livery. The Class 142, known as the Pacer, was introduced between 1985 and 1987, with 96 units built. The unit was designed to keep its costs as low as possible to develop and uses the road bus design as its model. The Pacer has no bogies and has axles bolted directly to its chassis, which can result in some defining ride characteristics. Alongside the Class 142, you will also be able to drive the BR Class 47 diesel locomotive and the BR Class 08 diesel shunter. These locomotives will provide you with a wide variety of experiences, meaning you can drive all kinds of services encompassing passenger, freight and parcel trains. Set the pace and enjoy the journey through the wide variety of changing scenery, local travel and train sim world. You can drive to the famous seaside resort of Blackpool, head south via some beautiful countryside to Ormskirk, or go on the freight only branch to Bernays. Look out for many landmarks along the way, such as the world-famous Blackpool Tower, the Blackpool Pleasure Beach, or even the Church of St. Walburgh's in Preston. Heading south, look for the Ribble Viaduct and Ainscombe Mill. Across the route, you will see characterful signal boxes and distinctive stations. Welcome to Blackpool Branches. Let the fun begin. Welcome to this Class 142 diesel mechanical multiple unit in British Rail Provincial Blue livery. This brief introduction will cover basic controls, stopping and passenger boarding. A lot of time will be spent in the cab, so climb aboard to get started. Before climbing on board, you will need to open the door via the external hatch. Start off by inserting the door key. Now you can open the hatch. This will give you access to the buttons which are located behind. Now you can press the open door button. This will release the doors. Before boarding the Class 142, you will need to close the hatch. Insert the door key to lock the panel. Enter the Class 142 and activate the guard's door panel by inserting the key and switching it to the on position. Now that you have activated the guard's panel, you will need to open the hatch above the door. This will give you access to the controls. Press the close button to shut the doors. Now that the doors have closed, you can shut the hatch. Finally, you will need to reinsert the key to deactivate the guard's panel. When ready, sit in the driver's seat. The master key is used to activate the control desk. Marker lights are used to inform others around you that this train is active. Give a quick glance at the platform to ensure all is safe, then unlock the doors. Boarding is now complete. Set the doors to locked. Use the reverser to set the direction of travel. Release the Westcode three-step braking system and apply power. Let's stop at the next station. The key aspect is to make a gentle and controlled approach. Stopping a train in the right place is the greatest skill of a train driver. It may take a few attempts to get it right, depending on the speed of the train. Begin braking between 1.5 and 1 mile from the station. Aim to be doing no more than 25 miles per hour when the train reaches the platform. Then come to a stop anywhere alongside. Give a quick glance at the platform to ensure all is safe, then unlock the doors. Boarding is now complete. Set the doors to locked. Continue along the circuit and practice the next stop before completing this training module.
Now, normally I would be doing a first look. However, I decided to change how I do these kind of videos going forward. Because of how life works with work and such things like that, I don't really get the time to do them in the daytime. So, I mean, it's currently where I am when I'm recording this. And I've had a little play around with this room and amazing. Just Trains have really done a really great job. From the route itself, it's well built. A lot of detail. Rolling stock's phenomenal. Got perfect sound, perfect physics. I think Skyhook and Rivet really need to learn from Just Trains, because you look at the quality of this one DLC, and you look at the quality of that DLC, and you can really see
why.
You can really see a difference. But anyway, we're in the 142 Pacer, which is my it's a guilty pleasure, I must admit.
Well done. This completes the basics of driving the Class 142.
I think for me it's a solid 10 out of 10, to be fair. See, I've done some services. I've just been having some fun on it. It's a really, really, really good route. And buy it. It is worth the money. It was £30, $40, and I want to say €40 or 35. One of them. But it is so worth it. For what you get. Yes, I know we only technically get one new train, but so much work has been done on the 47 and 08, so it's technically new. So if we do the 47 tutorial, and we'll do the 08, then I'll do an 08 service, followed by a 142 service, and we'll finish up with 47 service.
Welcome to the Class 47 locomotive in BR Corporate Blue livery. This brief introduction will go through startup, stopping, and passenger door operations. A lot of time will be spent in the locomotive cab, so climb aboard to get started.
And yes, they do feature nameplates.
To get the locomotive started, set the battery isolation switch.
I think there's 49 in total.
Sit in the driver's seat to get started. The master key is used to activate the control desk. Move the reverser into the engine-only position. The locomotive is now ready to be started. Use the straight air brake to hold the locomotive during the startup procedure.
I'm sorry, but just look at that. Oh.
Release the brakes to allow the system to charge. Use the reverser to set the direction of travel. High-intensity headlights and markers are used to inform others around. Almost ready. Release the remaining brakes. Increase the throttle to start moving. Do not apply too much power too quickly. It's important to provide a smooth ride for passengers.
Oh, I just sat there.
You know I have to do that. In the right place is a skill that takes years of practice. It might take a few attempts to get it right.
Damn the anchor.
Depending on the speed of the train, begin braking between 1 and 1.5 miles from the platform.
I'm still on.
Give a quick glance at the platform to ensure all is safe, then unlock the doors.
Also, the Mark II has new sounds. Wait. I think they also did some changes to some wiring, I think.
Good work. You have covered the basics of driving a Class 47 diesel locomotive.
Oh, is that all? Huh. Okay. Fair enough. Yeah, there is no introduction. Might as well get it out of the way.
Welcome to this Class 08 diesel-electric shunting locomotive in BR Corporate Blue livery. This brief introduction will go through the start and stop procedures. Before entering the locomotive, the battery isolation switches need setting. Start with the left side.
Alright, chaps. Is this the wig into it? Yeah. Oh, right side.
As with the left battery isolation switch, set the right side. Enter the cab and continue preparations. Active lights are important to let others around know that this locomotive is operational. A lot of time will be spent driving, so take a seat to continue. Go ahead and start the locomotive. Now that the engine is running, the master switch needs to be set. The main reservoir will take a moment to charge. This can be observed by watching the brake dials. To ensure that nothing moves while preparations continue, adjust the locomotive brake accordingly. The locomotive brake is holding the train, so the rest of the brakes can be released. Track alignment plays a large role when manoeuvring around a yard. Head out on foot and adjust the indicated junction as required.
No, I don't think I will.
The reverser is used to set the direction of travel. It's time to move. Set the locomotive brake as indicated. Increase the throttle to start moving. Do not apply too much power too quickly.
Let me get rid of this flipping vacuum. CSD. Release the vacuum. I think it'd be somewhere around here, wouldn't it? And where the heck is the vacuum stuff? There we are, I fixed it.
With the locomotive now moving, it's possible to apply more power and focus on achieving the desired speed. Coasting is a method to efficiently maintain a constant speed and reduce engine stress and maintenance requirements.
Yeah, that's proper clack that.
Make use of the brakes and throttle controls to manage the train and prevent overspeeding. Approaching the stop marker, apply a small amount of brake force to achieve a comfortable stop.
Yeah, really gotta practice that braking.
Work. That concludes all the basics.
Is that it? I'm sorry, but them tutorials were boring. I don't know, that's not their fault. But my God, that was boring. Yeah, I'll come back and do that at some point in my own time. But anyway, let's look at what we get. So let's start off with what subs in, so we get the class 31. And that's on passenger. It also does freight. Shunting. Mainly passenger. A couple of light locos and stuff like that. Class 45 is on passenger and a bit of like yard movement and stuff like that, as well as well, yeah, mainly shunting and stuff like that. Same with the 40, that's on, it's also does the freight and passenger. The steamer is on rail tour. The 20 is also on the rail tour. This will be coming in a video. Spoilers. The 101 subs in on the old, well, it has its own little set of services. But the 2-car variant also subs in for the Pacer. This is what the 08 has. Then we get 3 types of variety for the 47. So we've got the blue, the intercity swallow livery, and the large logo 47, which is awesome. And then we have the Pacer, which is the provincial 1985 to 91 two car. It's also got the 1985 to 91 orange livery and the 1993 plus provincial 1999 plus orange, the skipper livery, provincial 1989 to 1996, orange 89 to 96, skipper 89 to 96. So let's do an 08 service first. Welcome to Preston. Now at Preston. This is 8744. What's happening in Preston? We've got a 4-car Pacer. Oh, wonder what you are. Let's go have a nosy. Wrong button. So we've got... Hey? Oh, they ain't coupled, obviously not. Interesting. Should we see what's coming in? Hold yourself. Delivery. It's a Virgin. Virgin delivery, 47 minutes. The overhead wire detail in this room is phenomenal. We didn't even need to. Is this the Ribble Viaduct?
No.
It must be. Yeah, it is.
Oh dear, I'm tired.
That's alright. Yes, they have scripted the AI to blow their horns. There goes Thames.
gotta say, this is the best TSW for probably the best TSW I've had in a while. It's a real nice job. I'm not holding my breath though. You can hope. Which one's up? That's not a moment. This is Baskin. What life process? Named. Oh yeah, the CRT one is right, very nice.
Unnamed.
Hell, that have it all.
Thank you.
mine, that's cool. Oh, I never noticed that down there. And let's put it back in the siding. Nice one. So turn to the timetable. Wait for it to load, of course. Takes forever. In your own time. Thank you. So let's do a... Let's do OP66 Kirkham CE to Preston, Ladywell. I'm only going to do the short runs because I want to give everything an equal enough amount of time. But yeah, I seriously, go and get this ruby, it's amazing. I've got nothing but good things to say about it. So if you're, you know, if you're a negative Nancy, this isn't a video for you. It's very well put together.
where we've just come from. Over there. That's cool.
Just a bit of flag land.
Oh.
Look, there's a pacer.
This bloody fool too.
Yeah, I remember when pacers used to be like that.
Back in my days up to north.
Attention to detail, that's amazing. And there's a lot of clutter. It's not a group that likes clutter. Yeah. Random sea chems. Speed up. This is. Okay. I think. Yeah, okay. We're going to. 5.8 miles to Preston Goodsloop. So I hope you're enjoying Blackpool Branches as much as I am. It makes a nice change to get something set in the past and that isn't modern. I mean, yeah, modern is alright. It doesn't quite capture the character and the variety of classic past boots. I think it's a beautiful route. Salwick. This must be the Salwick facility. Nuclear I'm so enjoying this. And I hope, you know what? I hope this really sells well, because if this is the quality that one third party team can do, hell, this could be a game changer. Like, the quality of this could make other dev teams go, hang on a moment, what can we do, what these guys have done? That'll just make the game even better. And I hope this venture works well for Just Trains, and I hope one day they make more content, because it'd be awesome if they can. I'd be quite interested to see what Alan Thompson simulation comes up with, because I know they make some superb stuff for made some classic. Oh, hello, AWS. Yeah, this route only features AWS around Preston. If you're going to Blackpool North, South, Ormskirk, yeah, there's no AWS. But if you come into Preston and leave Preston, then you do get AWS. I reckon we're going up here somewhere. Waiting for the truck. Oh no, it's behind us. Checking the switches.
Do something.
Yeah, this is using the suspension mechanics for the first time, which is flipping awesome. I think it looks cool. Video, comment down below, boing, then I know you've got this far. Qualifies for my top groups of 2023. Listen to this.
The next station stop is Preston, where this train terminates.
That'd be awesome. Got announcements. Now, if you've got a keyboard,
Preston, where this train terminates.
I have a keyboard plugged into my Xbox Series X. Tells me to do that as well as any other keyboard commands. Or if you haven't got that keyboard, then just press that.
We'll shortly be arriving at
Preston, where this train terminates.
Get the fan work. Oh, that's bloody brilliant. Tell him, Tom.
The next stop is Preston, where this train terminates.
Tom. Actually, this service would go to York, not Leeds, same. May actually have done that rather than timetable with the book.
I noticed that door was open.
Ha, they've actually modelled a toilet.
Well, that's quite cool. Signalman's disappeared. Oh yeah, there's a new AWS thing on the HUD. I think it looks pretty good. Must admit, I purchased this copy myself. I did not get a review copy. I have not been given this as a sponsor. All thoughts are that of my own and don't include that of anyone I am employed by. Work with all my own thoughts and feelings. I mean, I wouldn't get a free copy anyway, I'm not an ambassador. That's not a dig at them, that's just not. Because they work hard to get where they are. It would be nice to get it on at some point, but
mm-hmm. unlock those doors that the poor passengers get off. Because, well, you know. Probably thinking, no, oh, let me off. Get out. I want to get off. Ah. What are the departures anyway? Awesome. Let's look at the scenarios and it'll be in a call it a night from me. Because it is like 2:45 in the morning. I am tired. We've got Blackpool Illuminations take control of one Zulu 09, an Illumination Special originating from Bournemouth. I wonder if Fentis is on that. Hauled by a Class 47 diesel locomotive, drive the final leg of the tour with 47555 from Preston to Blackpool North. Oiled up, sounds a bit wrong. Severe disruption on the West Coast main line has caused heavy delays to all services in the area. One service affected is your trip to Bernays, which has been stranded near Wellington Bank Quay. A path has been found, however, for the low delivery of the... Anyway. DMU debacle. A stranded patient needs your assistance. You must rescue this service and help get the self-flight branch back up and running again as soon as possible. Back and forth. Engineering works are taking place around the Salwick area, which means no services can reach Blackpool North or South. You will run a shuttle from service from Preston to Ormskirk and back again. Snow, however, has made its way across the north. Put a gronk on it. Having finished your morning break, you find yourself ready to get to work, shunting various coaching stock breaks around the Blackpool North area. Of course, like any other scenarios, they will be coming in their own videos, so yes, keep an eye out for them. So, final thoughts on Blackpool, Preston. Brilliant route. I recommend it highly. It is well worth the money for what you get. So yeah, and a quick note from me, please, I hate doing this. I mean, I really take it with a passion when others do it, but please like and subscribe because it helps me make these videos and keep putting the content out, and it also helps me towards making a bigger name for myself in the YouTube. So yeah, thank you all for watching. I'm going to go to bed. Goodbye for now.